I will be reviewing almost, not almost, exactly 18 different serums. All are Korean serums and I have used them up fully. All these are empty and majorly like I have used them up from time period of late 2018 to the beginning of this year, that is 2020. And since each serum can be used by different skin type and one serum does have various features, and just to make a little more sense out of this video and so that you people can understand things a bit better, hopefully I have decided to categorize this all these serum into two different categories. First one will be like serums for calming and brightening purpose, and second one would be serums for nourishment and skin repairing. The first serum is the Jumiso All Day Vitamin Brightening and Balancing Serum, and this serum has amazing lightweight gel-like texture which sinks into the skin beautifully without any stickiness, and this makes it perfect for this monsoon time as well as for the summer season. And this has some really amazing ingredients like 86% of sea buckthorn extract and 2% of niacinamide, and this does have ascorbic acid like the pure vitamin C serum, but since they have not mentioned the exact percentage of vitamin C, I'm expecting that it's somewhere around 2 or 3%, not more than that. So this makes it perfect as a gentle skin brightening serum for all skin types out there. But one thing I want to say, don't expect this to work on your deep acne scarring, but it definitely helps in fading the subtle brown spot, some red acne scar, and overall it gives that bright healthy skin. This does have a few essential oil in it, and which gives it this slightly citrusy and sweet scent to it. And the next serum is the Benton Snail Bee High Content Essence, and don't let the word essence fool you because this is technically a serum. And this again has a viscous gel like texture, but on application to your skin it sinks in completely without leaving any residue. And this contains some really amazing ingredients like snail mucin filtrate to repair and calm your skin. It also has bee venom to repair your skin. It also contains niacinamide and willow bark extract, and this is 100% essential oil free and is fragrance free. So this is something I feel that oily skin people should check out because it is perfect for you people, and combination skin can use this during the summer time. And this serum basically helps in calming down your skin. It overall gives that glow and brightness on your skin, and also it helps in keeping your pores clean, and clean pore means less breakout. So highly recommend it for the oily skin people. And the next serum is the Cosrx Centella Blemish Ampoule, and here I have the two empty bottles of it. And if you all know me, I love this particular ampoule mainly because it contains Centella Asiatica as its key active ingredient, and also it had this such lightweight, amazing but very hydrating texture. I mainly loved using this particular serum on days like when I had some irritation or any reaction from like testing out a new product, and this always helped in calming down my skin, helped in reducing the redness, and if I had any tiny zit or small pimple, it also calmed it down. So overall this had been like amazing product, and I have a feeling that the brand is planning, or they might have discontinued this because they have already launched their another Centella or Cica serum, so it really doesn't make sense to have two Centella based serum. So I don't know like what they have exactly decided, but this is just my opinion. And the next serum is the XY Curves Cica Green Serum, and this serum had like almost essence like texture, viscous but very lightweight, and on application to the skin it felt so calming and hydrating. And if you all remember, like during the beginning of this year I had a terrible skin damage issue, and this definitely helped a lot. I feel that everybody out there can use this serum, but the people with a sensitivity issue or dehydration issue will get the most benefit out of it. This is quite a fairly new brand. It was launched last year, and so you might not find it on various websites. And I did happen to find it on one particular website, and I have linked it in the description box below, so you can check it out just in case you are curious to try this particular product. And the next serum is the Innisfree Bija Seeker Essence, and again this is not an essence but more like a serum and a discontinued product. Like in this video I do have quite a lot of discontinued product anyways. So this is basically nothing but a very similar product to their Bija Seeker Skin, which I have reviewed and used in this video over here. They both have milky consistency, which on application to your skin turn into a watery consistency, and it feels very hydrating and more calming in nature. And this also didn't have any fragrance or essential oil packed with the goodness of Centella Asiatica. So overall this had been a good product. And the next serum is the Cosrx Mela 14 White Ampoule, another discontinued product. And this was basically the skin calming, acne treating and acne scar fading product, because it contained both AHA, BHA and niacinamide. And I really couldn't use this particular product because the formulation went bad. No, the product was not expired, or I even stored it properly away from the direct sunlight in a really good condition, but for some reason, like in 3-4 months the formula went bad. Like if you have a closer look, the solid part, they got separated from the liquid part, and the sedimentation process occurred. And I contacted the brand if this was normal, can I continue using this. They suggested not to use it, and so I discarded the product. And the next serum is the Skin Miso Pore Corset Serum, and this serum had a slightly cloudy, viscous but runny texture, and on application to the skin it felt cooling and calming. But I mainly bought this particular serum to test it out on pores. So me and my mom, we both used it up for our very different skin types, and it did shrink the pores, but only for maximum 2 hours, and after that the pores did go back to their original size. So we mainly used it up as more like a hydrating and cooling serum for summer. And the next serum is the Natural Pacific Fresh Herb Origin Serum. The year I bought it, the brand was known by the name of Natural Pacific, and then they later changed it to Nesific. So if you are looking out for this product, search it by the name of Nesific. So this is basically a bi-phased solution product, and it contained some oils for skin barrier improvement, like sunflower oil, argan oil, jojoba oil, and it also contains sea buckthorn seed oil to brighten up your skin tone, and some bunch of citrus fruit extract. And this serum, like, so you need to shake it up before you use it on your skin. So this serum is like supposed to brighten up your skin tone, smoothen out your rough skin texture, and overall improve the condition of your skin. So like it does have some really good claims to it, and the year I bought it, it was quite famous at that time. And so this serum, like initially when you use it on your skin, it is supposed to sting, and that's very common. And when you use it more and more over the time, as it improves the condition of your skin, it should not sting. But in my case it happened other way around. Like on initial application it did not sting my skin, and as I used it more and more, it actually started stinging, and it dehydrated my skin very badly, and it also caused some dark dull patches on my skin. So I stopped using it and passed it on to my mom, and she used it up mainly. But she was also not very happy with this product, because she found it weird overall, because we both had issue with how it smelled. To me it mostly smelled like a cheap citrusy bathroom cleaner. Yeah, so I don't know, overall this had been a very weird and bad product. So the first serum in this category is the I'm From Ginseng Serum, and this has a bouncy viscous texture, and it does have this brown color to it, and it's not due to any artificial coloring but naturally due to the addition of ginseng in it. And it contains red ginseng extract and ginseng seed oil all together in 7.98%, and this is quite high percentage, and for the price that you're paying, it's a really good percentage, because usually ginseng based products are quite costly. And I overall liked this product because it hydrated my skin, it nourished my skin, and did give that healthy, dewy, slightly bright skin. And only one thing that I'm not happy about this serum is the fragrance in it. Like, they have added some artificial fragrance to it. Like, it has this slightly bitter but mostly floral scent. So I hope they tone it down in the future batches, because sensitive skin out there, and some of you who doesn't like fragrance in their product might not like this product. And the next set of empty serums that I will be reviewing contain propolis as the key ingredient. And the first one is the Cosrx Propolis Light Ampoule, and previously it used to come in this 20ml glass bottle packaging, and last year or maybe late 2018 they changed the packaging to this plastic 30ml bottle. And this does have a viscous texture, and it mainly contains 86% of propolis extract, and has very simple ingredient list, and it is essential oil free, fragrance free, so it makes it perfect for the sensitive skin. And overall I really liked this serum for hydration and to add that nourishment to my dull dry skin. And with the regular usage, it definitely added that healthy glow on the skin, and I feel that all skin types can use this particular serum. And the next serum is the Bivistrin Polyphenol in Propolis 15% Ampoule, and this also has a viscous bouncy texture just like the Cosrx one, but comparatively lightweight. So the key ingredient of this serum is the Huttania cordata, like this ingredient over here, in good 59%, and it contains propolis in 15%, and it also has zinc PCA. This is 100% essential oil free and is fragrance free. So performance wise, this definitely hydrated my skin, they definitely nourished my skin, it definitely added that healthy glow on my skin, but more than that, I felt it more calming in nature. It definitely reduced the redness on my skin, and if I had small tiny zit, it definitely calmed it down. I don't know why people call this as a propolis serum. It is not a 100% propolis serum, but more like a skin calming product with propolis as one of its ingredient. So anyways, I feel that if you have oily and combination skin, and if you want to check out a propolis based product for your skin type, this is something you should definitely check out, because I'm sure you people will love it. And the next propolis product is the Skinfood Royal Honey Propolis Enriched Essence, and this also has viscous, bouncy, nourishing texture which sinks into the skin beautifully, making the skin soft and hydrated. And this contains 63% of propolis extract, and it doesn't have any essential oil, it doesn't have any fragrance, and if you sniff it really hard, you might find a hint of sweet honey fragrance to it, and it is mainly due to the ingredients used in it. Otherwise it barely has any fragrance. And for the performance, it definitely hydrated my skin, it definitely nourished my skin, it definitely added that healthy, dewy, honey skin glow in the least amount of time. And additionally, it also calmed down my skin, it also helped in reducing the redness, and if I had small tiny zit or small pimple, it also calmed it down. So overall, this had been an amazing product, and in fact this is my most favorite propolis based product, and is definitely one of my favorite serum from the Korean skincare. And the next serum is the Dr. Jart Cyrimidine Serum, and it has really rich cream-like texture, and the key ingredients include 5 different types of ceramide, fatty acid, cholesterol, and some bunch of good botanical extract. And for the performance, I definitely liked it. It definitely moisturized my skin, helped in repairing the skin barrier, but I feel if you already have the moisturizer from this range, the Cyrimidine cream, you really don't need this serum, because this serum and the cream, they are literally the same thing. I hardly find any difference in them. So you really don't need to buy two similar products. Like, it doesn't make any sense. But still, if you want to try, I feel that dry skin people only can use it. Rest might find it sticky. And the next product is the Innisfree Jeju Lava Sea Water Boosting Ampoule. And this product is made to provide that hydration and anti-aging benefit to the skin. And you can use this serum alone as a boost for hydration, but it is recommended that you pick one or two booster or effector according to your skin concern. Like in the picture you see, I chose the Cica one to calm my skin and the firming one for that anti-aging benefit, and I added those two effector to this ampoule. Like completely I emptied those booster completely and then I shaked it well so that the solution becomes more homogeneous and ready to use. So anyways, like for the performance, this has been nothing special. It was more like a hydrating serum and nothing else. So if you are wondering where you can get it, you can only get it on the selected Innisfree store and on few selective Korean website. And the next product is the Innisfree Olive Real Serum X. And this serum had a very rich cream-like texture. And I personally love the Innisfree Olive range because it's affordable and is perfect for the very dry skin people like me. And since like whatever I've tried from this range, I loved it. That is why I bought this serum. But I found it way too sticky for me. I like used it for a while during the winter time, and then when summer came, I started using this as a hand cream because it's very, very rich and it's only suitable for the winter time. So if you're planning to get this, get it only if you have very dry skin and during the winter time. Otherwise, you can pass on this one. Next, I will be sharing three discontinued serum because they are discontinued or modified. There is no point talking about them in detail, so I will only be sharing my personal experience. The first serum is the AGM Hyal B5 Ampoule. Not just the product, but the brand itself is renamed and it is now known as Dr. Ciricle. So this ampoule was more like a hydrating product for me and nothing more than that. The next product is the Innisfree Green Tea Moisture Essence. And since this had a lotion-like texture, I used it up as a moisturizer during the summertime, and that's all. I'm done with this. And the next product is the Tony Moly Goat Milk Whitening Essence. And this is again a serum that had milky consistency, and I bought it because it claimed to brighten up your skin tone, help in fading the scarring, and also it had such amazing ingredients like niacinamide, vitamin C, salt. Also, it contains ceramide 3, and the goat milk naturally helps in brightening up your skin tone. So but overall I found it okay. It was more like a hydrating moisturizing serum and that's all, nothing more than that. Since I have reviewed so many serums, lot of them were just okay and some of them are discontinued or at the verge of getting discontinued, I'm sure this must have gotten very confusing. So let me just share my top 4 serums from this lot, like from all the serums that I've reviewed. So the serum to rank at the 4th position is the XY Co's Cica Green Serum. And if you're dealing with the very, very bad dehydrated skin issue, this is something you need to check out. Serum to rank at the 3rd position is the Jumiso Brightening and Balancing Serum. I especially love it for the summertime because it's ultra lightweight and also it helps in brightening up the skin tone. And the serum to rank at the 2nd position is the Cosrx Centella Blemish Ampoule. And I know this is soon to be discontinued product, but I have to mention it because this had been saving my skin from 2017 and I loved it for my sensitive skin. And yes, I'm definitely like waiting to try out their Cica serum. So once I do, I will definitely let you know whether the Cica version is as good as this one or not. So the serum to rank at the 1st position is the Skinfood Royal Honey Propolis Enrich Essence. And for some reason, this works amazingly on my skin. It hydrates, it nourishes, it adds that glow on my skin. And if I'm going through with some irritation or small breakout, it also calms down my skin. So highly, highly, highly recommended for the dry skin people especially. Like I love this product so much. So that's all for this video, and I know there was nothing special about this video. It was more like a casual empties video, but I hope you liked it. And if you have any recommendation or any product that you want me to check out, comment down below and I will see you next time. Bye.